My life has always been the same. Same school, same community, same friends, same everything. And I've never had any complaints. Going through senior year, college applications just felt like a process I wanted to get over with. Upon being forced to visit colleges by my mom, Boston was first on the list, and Northeastern was first on the application list. I loved the community, campus, academics, location, everything. I wanted to go there. I needed to. Sitting at school randomly, my mom texts me, "Check your email, check your email." I thought maybe she sent me a funny picture of a cat or something ridiculous like normal. But I opened my email and saw Northeastern University in big bold letters. You should have seen the expression on my face. I looked like a fat kid who had just won cake. It wasn't until I got home later that night that I would be told I was accepted into the NUN program, not Northeastern. A program I had never heard of before, particularly the whole concept of the NUN program I had never heard of before. I had questions and wanted answers. Now you've shared my first thoughts with me. My name is Robert Deffenbaugh, and this is the story of my NUN experience in Thessaloniki, Greece. On the flight to my new temporary home, I sat by myself, literally my own row. Barely knowing a few kids, I felt alone, and the symbolism didn't make me feel any better. Soon enough, though, everything changed. We all started forming relationships, and I realized everyone was in the same boat. Particularly, I liked the Greek god groups, and the sense of camaraderie I felt when we would break down into smaller communities. It allowed for each of us to introduce ourselves and have the opportunity to talk to someone I might not have spoken with otherwise. After a week of orientation, we finally had classes. My curriculum included ecological principles, microeconomics, business calculus, and the oh-so-helpful Greek language. We also have a mandatory global experience course with a frowned-upon wake-up time of 8:15 a.m. But this class has perks. Recently, we spent our allotted global experience time with a partner, walking around Aristotelos Square, asking strangers multiple questions about their views on politics, economies, and the inhabitants, for both Greece and America. One man felt anger towards Americans, particularly Barack Obama, but thankfully didn't mind study abroad students, while the other expressed his emotion about his family's safety from the unstable economy, and spoke about the corruption here in Greece. This was the first real time we were able to engage ourselves with the Greek community and witness a historical benchmark firsthand. Along with global experience, we also have our weekly dose of volunteer work through service learning. Originally, every Tuesday after school, I would take an hour-long bus ride to the outskirts of the city and coach at a youth organization called Asfestachori Sports Center. Coming from a sports background, I figured I would fit right in. Since the first day there, I felt my time there was wasted and had an overall unsatisfactory engagement with the organization. One thing led to another, and I found myself switching to teaching college students English and counseling them with their college decisions. First day there, I find myself in another unorganized service learning. We show up with four of us and one student to tutor. Our interactions with the student are minimal and awkward. Overall, I was disappointed with both of my service learning organizations and wish I could have participated in a more proactive and beneficial community service experience. Recently, I got a little taste of relaxation when my three friends and I treated each other to a well-deserved spa day. Massages and facials? You bet. For further relaxation and exercise, we play basketball at the local courts and even go for a run on the boardwalk, where you can get a pretty nice city view. Although the best view by far was the night of the hike up Mount Olympus. The hike itself was beautiful, but the best part was, that night, we could see every star in the sky. Along with all of our adventures and constant travel, we spend a lot of time chilling at our hotel. I have to be honest, it's a love-hate relationship between the hotel and I. If it isn't the mold-encrusted AC, it's the lack of power, the sketchy elevator, or the randomly freezing cold to scalding hot shower. One facet that separates me from the rest of the other 114 students is that I taxi to school every day my schedule permits. I wake up at 11, hop in the shower, get ready, and am outside by 11:30. From there, I head to one of the many local bakeries. Most of the time, I go to Anapsik Tuyo and get the meat pastry, also pronounced Lukani Kapita, aka pigs in a blanket, accompanied by my daily calcium intake through chocolate milk. Another great addition is the randomness of the taxi drivers. Sometimes I'll get lucky and they will speak a little English, but normally it's a struggle to communicate where I want to go. Though, each time I get into the cab, I attempt to converse with the little Greek I know, typically ending in a two-sentence conversation of what's your name and where are you from. As far as the trip as a whole, I cannot say I have one favorite experience because solely me being here is 89 days of remarkable experiences. But if I had to choose, it would probably be my ability to globalize not one city, but multiple cities and cultures that I may never have the opportunity to immerse myself in again. Just in my time here in Greece, I've explored London, Amsterdam, Istanbul, and various Greek cities. all places with deep cultural history, eclectic people, intertwined customs, and good food, a key factor during my city selection. In each city, even Thessaloniki, I've tried to live up to the Inuan slogan, break out of the ordinary, a phrase motivating us to go out of our comfort zone, do something I might not normally do, and just be the crazy teenager I want to be. Hopefully, with my experiences and many lessons learned here, I can help globalize Boston, back home in Kansas, and wherever else my life takes me.